Hello, I am Bonnie Pineda. I am a 53-year-old lifter, welder, and business owner of Pinoy Home Gym. So, ngayong araw, actually, I listed down yung mga topics that I want to talk about. I want to introduce my company, yung Pinoy Home Gym, and the training style that I am trying to promote. So, let's start with yung Pinoy Home Gym. Pinoy Home Gym is a strongman equipment company. So, it's not like yung mga regular gym equipment company. We are not selling, or I'm not building and selling yung mga regular na mga gym equipments that you will find in the commercial sports shops and yung mga local gym equipment companies. Okay, so what I build are strongman equipment, specifically for recreational strongman training. So what is recreational strongman training? So this is different from yung strongman as a sport. It evolved from there, pero it's not meant for competitive training. Kasi sa strongman, there are two elements that are present, no? So strongman competitive, no? Competition. So there is yung functionality, yung movements that are significant to real life, yung mga real life physical activities, physical labor, and there's also the element of danger. So they are lifting yung mga obscure objects that can lead to injuries kasi yung mga shape ng mga objects na binubuhat sa strongman competition are different, no? Like mga strange, mga ano, uncomfortable yung mga binubuhat ng mga implements. That's part of the sport. So, I also build those, yung mga competitive na mga equipment for competition. But what I want to talk to you about is yung, particularly, yung equipment na that I am designing, I am building, and I am selling for recreational strongman training. So, ano ba yung recreational strongman training? Yung first niya is yung functionality and yung how similar it is, how useful it is to yung real life activities, no? I'm already an old guy and alam niyo kung sa mga kabataan yung strength training and yung mga weightlifting is just a hobby. For people who are in my age category, it is something that is really very important already because at this age, you can already feel yung weakening trying to creep in. Yung loss of strength, loss of stamina, and loss of yung mga physical attributes. Medyo it's real, no? Nangyayari na yon. It's trying to creep in, no? So yung training sa amin, sa akin, at least sa akin, iba na yung meaning. It's not anymore for aesthetics, to look good. It's really for maintaining strength and being strong until the last years of my life, no? So even yung definition of training already changes. As much as possible, strength is not relevant unless there is fitness. So stamina, yung cardio, strength, power, sama-sama na yan. Hindi na siya parang hiwa-hiwalay. Kasi lahat yung mga components na yon kailangan for yung regular physical activities. So at this stage, yung Pinoy Home Gym, talagang dinesign ko na rin siya to address these needs, no? Before, we used to do mga racks, we used to do benches, but not anymore. Kasi nag-iba na yung definition ng exercise. Yung lying down, we only lie, siguro akin, sa akin, lying down, pag matutulog na lang. Sitting down, pag magpapahinga na lang. Sa akin, ang definition ko of exercise now is standing up, preferably moving. If it's not standing up and moving, for me, it's no longer exercise. It's no longer relevant. Because that's what I am trying to avoid at my age. Sitting down and lying down. I like to be active and mobile. So, kaya that's why I went into strongman. but recreational strongman para tanggalin yung elements of danger. So, sa akin, yung lifting is, well, lifting is improved strength, but for you to have any value in real life, you have to be able to carry what you can lift. Because let's face it, ano, yung mga gagawin naman natin sa buhay, unless what you're going to do is you're going to lift the couch so you can, pwede mo walisin yung sahig underneath it, lifting doesn't have any value in real life labor or anything that's useful in life. Whatever you have to lift, you have to take it somewhere. You have to take heavy objects from point A to point B to accomplish work. Practical work. Everyday work. Ganun talaga. So, yung recreational strongman training basically involves lifting and carrying. But unlike yung competitive strongman, we remove the element of danger. What we are carrying and what we are lifting and carrying are objects that are safe to handle. So, that's the only equipment that I am pushing. No? Like, for example, pag narinig natin strongman, we always think of stones. We always think of logs. Well, I don't do that anymore because these are objects that are part of the sport, but I don't think that they are musts in recreational strongman training kasi may danger involved eh. Kasi very obscure, uncomfortable yung objects na ito to lift. Okay? So, let's go now to equipment. Like I said, yung my equipment that I am designing, building, and selling are different from what you will see in other stores. Because I mainly focus on functionality. Kumbaga, yung mga ginagawa ko equipment, yung mga equipment na pangharabas. Yung equipment na hindi maselan. Okay? First of all, yung pricing niya is not something na you will worry na, ay, naku, kakalawangin. Ay, naku, masisira. Masisira. Kumbaga, that's part of it. Kumbaga, sa akin kasi, sa pag-exercise, ang bida hindi equipment. Ang bida yung nag-exercise. So, yung nag-exercise should not worry kung masisira equipment niya. No? Because it's your equipment na yun para sa'yo. Hindi yung ikaw yung para sa equipment, para alagaan mo siya. So, yung mga equipment na binibenta ko at ginagawa ko, hindi yung mga equipment na alagain. In fact, what I am building are outdoor equipment because as much as possible, I think exercise should be done outdoors, hindi sa loob ng kwarto. You should be there with the elements under the sun, with the wind flowing and touching your face. Ganun ang aking concept of sport. And practically lahat, halos majority of sports naman, ganun. You're outdoors. Okay? So, yung ginagawa ko are outdoor equipments. For example, yung mga bars and the other bar handles that I am constructing are made of GI pipes na dinadaanan ng tubig yan. Talagang that's made to handle water. So, hindi kakalawangin for how many years. And then, instead of plates, what I'm using are tires, car tires. So, talagang pangkalsada yan. Talagang ibinabaksak yan. Talagang pinagugulong sa kalsada yan. And these are cars that are handling tons of weight, no? Kasi kotse ang bigat. Yun ang hinahandle ng mga gulong. So, I chose to use these materials para I can say that yung mga materials na gagamitin for recreational strongman training ng Pinoy Home Gym are matibay. Kasi pang kotse ito, hindi naman pang... Kumbaga, exercise lang yan eh. Ito, ginagamit sa kalsada for transportation. So, it should be able to handle that easily. And like I said, yung equipment, hindi yan ang bida. Hindi yan yung... Kumbaga sa t-shirt, well, of course, there are people who would like to wear branded clothing. But that's like equipment, no? Other than those people, I think, ang bida talaga, yung taong gumagamit. So he should not worry about kung kakalawangin, dahil mahal, sayang, mahal, makamasira. Equipment, gym equipments should be pangharabas. So yun ang focus ng Pinoy Home Gym. Okay? So... ano pa ba? What else hindi ko na-touch? Okay, so, actually, yun lang. Wala na akong maisip for now, no? So, that's it. Until I can, siguro, think of something else to tell you about recreational strongman training and the strongman equipment that Pinoy Home Gym is selling. Okay, sige, thank you. Bye for now. Live strong.